Greetings, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Thursday, and hopefully it will be a good Thursday. Oftentimes, as I say, Thursday's a little bit of turbulence, but we work our way through it and perhaps get ready for a little more freedom and leadership and future thinking on Friday, and we will do that tomorrow, because the program I was going to talk about today was entitled, Hey, You Have to Be Different, or I Can't Help You. Or You May Have to Want to Be Different, or I Can't Help You. Well, that was scheduled for today, but in the meantime, I had the wonderful opportunity as a result of meeting a new friend. His name is Lee, and he is one of the leaders of the Rotary Club in the small city of Clayton, North Carolina, just about 30 miles from the Raleigh-Durham area where Karen and I now hang out. And I met him again online through a mutual relationship, as they said, if you want to know something about that and the Rotary leadership, you have to talk to one of our good guys. And they just simply gave me the name of Lee. And so I reached out to him and found out a couple things. First of all, what a wonderful, brave, and courageous man he is. And he's going through, as I went through about 5-6 years ago, through the cancer ordeal. And so we kind of cultivated an online relationship. So we finally decided to meet in person. And so he said, hey, come on down for the meeting. We meet on Thursday. We're an early club, but we're at 7 o'clock. You're welcome to join me as my guest. And so I did just that. And it's the usual kind of Rotary experience. Lots of friendly people getting ready to have breakfast, have a good meeting, and look like a good time. But I've also been to similar meetings in any kind of situation where, you know, the meeting doesn't really live up to all of what you had expected. Well, this turned out to be an exceptional meeting, and so I'd like to talk to you about it today under the question and perhaps the comment. First question, do you have an audience? Do you have an audience? Well, I'm going to help you answer that question by saying, yes, you probably do. And then here's a statement. After the speaker was done and I met her later and I just simply said, you need a bigger audience. Thank you so much for the talk, but you need a bigger audience. Well, today, with your permission, I'd like to tell you a little bit of the story behind both of those statements and a little bit about, I kind of had tears inside. They didn't quite come out, but I was so deeply moved by a story today that I heard from a wonderful African-American woman success story from Clayton, North Carolina, and I'm going to tell you a little bit about it today. Hey, the program is Interesting Ideas, and it comes from interesting people, and the program begins right now. So here we go. Here's what happened to me on this Thursday. Let's see. 12th or 13th. I think it's the 13th of April here in North Carolina. And it's a beautiful day. Beautiful sunshiny day. Hey, here's what happened. First of all, the Rotary Club got off to a great start. They had a wonderful breakfast. Perfect, right down the line. And then they began with the prayer of invocation for the way the world is and some of the situations that they were aware of. And then they went around and they had what is called happy bucks. And what they do is they pass a bucket and everybody's expected. I guess I'm immune from that since I'm a guest. You put in a buck and you tell what you're happy for today. And then that goes to a very important cause, particularly for research on what is going to strike many of us this day and age, the Alzheimer's Foundation. And so it was great to start the morning where everybody talking a little bit about something that they were happy about and grateful for that day. Then they went on and finally did, you know, those things that they do in meetings and announcements and having some good time and featuring a new member, a new guest, you know, again, affirm all you can, people within your own circle of friendship. And then they invited a guest. And the guest was someone who was very much connected to my friend Lee. In fact, she was also a guest for him, of him, along with me, who just happened to drop in as per his invitation that day. And it turns out, I'm not going to use her name because I don't have permission at this time, but the story was that a number of years ago, my friend Lee started a youth club. This is back, you know, in the 80s and 90s, difficult times, cocaine, crisis. Again, very similar to what we have in many parts of our communities today. And the story was of a young woman, and she actually was in the youth club that my friend Lee and his partner had started. And it was an after-school club, and it was primarily, and I heard this term of, you know, ACE, you know. These were, you know, adverse childhood experiences for those children who are having adverse childhood experiences. And of course, when that happens, lots of bad things happen. And how do we deal with that? Well, she was one of the candidates as a young gal who was in that situation. But thank goodness, thanks to the youth club and then some other mentoring, even though she came from that very difficult situation, she was able to excel in her school and to the friendship and mentorship and the collegiality from this club that had been started, and went on to graduate very much at the top of her class in high school, which was unusual in its sense, which says something obviously about her in terms of smart, and clever, and unique, but obviously somewhat of a overcomer. Went on to college, and then went on to law school, and did very well, and she is now very much in a leadership position, trying to help and has mountainous responsibilities and opportunities within the juvenile justice program of the state of North Carolina, in which they're trying so much to try and not only reduce the number of juveniles who are put in incarceration and seeing if they can do, because that may keep them out of trouble, but unfortunately, oftentimes when they leave the incarceration center, they simply learned a little bit about how they could be at greater risk of having a difficult life. And if we can get them instead into strong community centers where they are kept in control and under leadership and under sponsorship, and obviously, in some cases, disciplined and held accountable in a community center, within a school, within a church, within a family, within a community that will help. You know, in this sense, it takes a community sometimes to help a child that's in trouble. So that was the story she told. And it was a fascinating story. I was deeply moved by it. And here she was. And she was coming back after a number of years, and she spoke to the very people who had actually been a part of helping her up. And then she gave as pictures and stories of the various other role models that she had had, and oftentimes they were also successful African-American women who particularly had landed up in roles in the legal system, even becoming judges, that had served as her mentors and models, so that she now has a wonderful position of influence and compassion and care for the juvenile justice system. And particularly, as she said, what we try and do is see if we can keep them out of my system. Is there a way that we can come in and do some work so that they don't land up in the juvenile justice system? And of course, that is the ideal that we should strive for. So that was my experience this morning. And as I said, I was deeply moved by it. And I thought, yeah. And in the midst, and of course, here's the real contrast. After having that wonderful experience, then, of course, I got back in my car, and now I turned on the radio, and here we hear some of the news of the day, particularly the situation where seemingly a young group of young men have gotten in this incredible, very damaging intelligence leak that's going through the United States government is basically a group of gaming young men who broke the system and are leaking all of these things that who knows whether they should be held in confidence or not, but obviously there's a lot of damage to people who might be compromised as a result of all the things that are being said there. And then, of course, the rest of the news follows. And I just said a simple prayer to God. I said, you know, thank you, God, that I, at least this morning, had a touch very much, as the woman said. She said, I don't know if you believe in God or not, but I do. And obviously, he had some plans for my life and people who helped those plans come true. And there it was. Now, when I introduce myself, because, you know, they do that. You got to stand up and they say, just give us a word. And I try to keep those really short. And I just simply said, I'm Stan. I'm here in Carolina. It's because of some help for my family, and I'm very grateful for all this wonderful place. And then my business is What It Takes Radio, and we are in the business of helping you reach your audience. That's what we do, and if we can help you, good for us and good for you. Hey, with a smile, after the program, I went over and I said to her just exactly this. Remember I said, we all have an audience. And then I looked at her and said, you know, I loved your story. It was wonderful. It touched me deeply. And you need to have a bigger audience. You need to, more and more people need to hear your story. Because it's certainly a story of inspiration and encouragement. And certainly instruction. So perhaps those of us who certainly are upset about the state of our youth in many ways can rally around those people who are trying to protect our youth and to rehabilitate and reconstruct those youth who've had, you know, an adverse childhood experience. So that's my story for today. And thoughts and prayers and tributes to the people who do that same kind of work. And of course, those are the people we hardly ever hear about. They don't make celebrity status. All they do is save their community and save the lives of children and others. You know, no big deal. They aren't famous. They aren't celebrities. Oh, they are what it's all about. They are indeed what it's all about. And the only thing perhaps we should do is make sure they get a bigger audience so more and more people can be helped and encouraged. That's what we do, and that's my story for this Thursday. I'm Stan Houston. If I can be of help to you, please reach out to me. at stanhusted@gmail.com, stanhusted@gmail.com. We're going to try and see if we can get some of these people also on the Interesting Ideas radio program. If you know stories like that, if you'd like to recommend some people we need to talk about and some of the people we need to meet, and perhaps you have I have a story to tell, I'd like to be on the program, well, we would be happy to audition your story for Interesting Ideas. All the best and blessings to you, and may the weekend coming up go well for you. And tomorrow I will talk about that subject is, you know what? Do you want to be different? Because if you don't, I can't help you. Now, what in the world does that mean? Well, let's see tomorrow. Take care, and bye for now.